So I'm looking forward to this. We're heading out to Carthage, Missouri, to the Burlingame and Chaffee Opera House.
Yeah, and what's kind of cool about this case is the gentleman who called us in, he'd never even believed in the supernatural at all.
His big concern is he feels like something in there just does not want him there. We definitely need to just help him out.
Taps case, Burlingame and Chaffee Opera House, Carthage, Missouri.
Hi, how are you?
Good. I'm Jason.
Hi, I'm Keith.
It's nice to meet you.
Hey, Keith, I'm Steve.
Hi,
how
Steve.
You doing? Nice to meet you.
You want to bring us in and show us around?
Yeah, just come up this way.
Our client, Keith McBride, has experienced a series of unexplained and frightening events since purchasing the building and restoring the Opera House, as well as running an antique shop on the main floor.
When I first purchased the building, I thought somebody had broken into the building because there's nobody up here. And after a while, you're like, what's going on?
And how long have you owned the building for?
I purchased the building 3 years ago in June.
What's some of the history here?
In 1878, this was the Opera House, and it ran until 1893. And then for a few years after that, it was the Turner Harness Factory. They purchased the building in 1905.
Through the centuries, different floors have housed various businesses, including a mortuary in the basement. It's believed that each floor experiences hauntings related to different eras of the building's history.
I looked over and I seen this man and woman. This man was dressed in a three-piece suit. The woman was dressed in a white dress from the late 1800s. I know beyond a shadow of a doubt this place is haunted.
The top floor is the Opera House, where claims seem to be tied to the turn of the 20th century.
In the Opera House, I saw a black mist that was in a humanoid shape that was at the front of the building in the old cash box area. It was pretty creepy.
Keith has even provided Taps with a photo of a supposed apparition near the windows. The main floor is Keith's antique store, where claims are believed to be connected to the 1930s and beyond.
It wasn't so long ago even I saw an entity right in front of me.
What type of entity?
She looked just like the lady in American Gothic. She just walked right in front of me, and then she turned her head away and completely disappeared. And then I realized that I couldn't see her feet.
You couldn't see her feet?
I could not see her feet.
Towards the back, I heard an older stern lady, and she said, stop running. And immediately, I kind of just paused, looked around for a second, and, you know, thought to myself, did I hear what I thought I just heard? It just took off.
So is there anything else you want to fill us in on?
This was really weird to me. I came up here one night and noticed an illuminated three in the floor. And exactly 3 months to the day is when the fire in the building next door happened.
3 months to the day?
To the day, an unattended candle was left burning and took down the whole building.
Wow.
In the basement, people claim to have seen and heard a young girl who is believed to be the victim of a runaway carriage accident in the late 1800s. She and her mother died when they were flung from their carriage and pulled into flooded tunnels that ran under the building.
It was about closing time. It was all quiet. Nobody was in here. And I heard a little girl scream. And that was kind of freaking me out.
Keith's fear reached a critical point recently after he was overcome by the feeling of something trying to push him down the stairs.
I came up here and headed down that stairway, and something just jumped on me. It was like 400 pounds, and it was trying to force me down the stairs. I grabbed onto the side of the wall, and I just held on for dear life. It lasted about 10 to 15 seconds, and it was off me. I felt like it was trying to kill me.
Jeez. What are you hoping we're able to accomplish here, though?
Well, first I'd like to know, why would you attack me and my employees? If you could find out what's going on, who's here, you know, just kind of give me maybe a peace of mind that, you know, or let them know somehow that I'm here, I own it, I'm not going anywhere, and all I want to do is just continue to restore the building.
All right.
Well, we're going to do our best, for sure, you know.
And we'll go talk to the rest of the crew and start figuring out how to start setting up, right?
All right, sounds great. Thank you, Jason.
No, thank you. My only concern with what he just said was perfect entity missing its feet.
That seems inhuman, doesn't it?
Maybe we're not dealing with human or intelligent type haunts here.
We need to be on guard a little bit tonight, you know.
Let's just
for now, anyway.
Watch out what's going on.
Yeah. Thanks. Thank you.
So we just finished talking with Keith on the Burlingame and Chaffee Opera House, and he was filling us in about a lot of the claims that they've had over here. Everything from seeing apparitions to feeling like they're being pushed down the stairs. Keith is truly scared. He's scared for his safety, his family's safety, and he just wants to know what's going on here. But he did bring up some things that would lead me down that path of believing that we're dealing with something more malicious.
Just want to see if you have eyes on this full spectrum camera on the stairwell.
It's good to have Dustin here investigating with us. You know, he's like a brother to me. He's been with me for many, many years.